E2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
First one is open browser. Launch ebay.com.
We can see your screen. Come on.
Oh, what about others? Hello, can you all see? Others can see my screen. I think Pandu, you are asking, right? Others can see my screen. Can you check it?
Now, it is fine.
Okay, fine. See here, launch ebay.com, and here enter camera something. Okay, enter camera here. I'm talking about here. Okay, enter camera, and then click on the search button. Okay, so we'll enter camera here. You click on search. Probably we'll click on this this daily deals or sell. Okay. Probably sign in also. We'll go to this daily deals. Okay. Say this is our scenario. This is our test case. I want to automate this one. Okay. Now here I'm taking a new. Now be interactive. Now you have to guide me in writing this script. EB without recording. Okay. Yep. Can you all guide me? Can you post your guesses over here in the chat box? First step is, here we want to automate, open browser. Now what I have to do here, first of all I have to write a method, right? Class should contain methods. So public void, let me say search. Search was our method name. Okay. Here first thing is we want to open the browser. Yep. Can you post your guesses? If I want to open a browser, what I have to do? Yep, we have to create the instance for the Firefox thread, right? So Firefox, okay, let me say browser. New Firefox driver. And from where this Firefox driver get into picture? We did not create, right? We did not create this Firefox driver. Yes, we did not create this Firefox driver. This is the class which is internal to the Selenium. Here, which is already imported here. Import org.openqa.selenium, which is a part of Selenium web driver interface. Okay, this is a class. Okay, this is a class. Here, it is a part of this Selenium QA. Okay. So now we are successfully opening the browser. Now next step is we want to open ebay.com here. Now, if I want to open a browser, what I can do here? What I have to do? So, where you want to open this URL? Within this browser. So, this browser dot get. Okay. Here, give the URL of the application. And if you remember, I said here one recommendation is you have to make sure that there should be HTTP. Okay. Now we are successfully opening the browser. After that, we want to enter camera. Now, how can I achieve this? If I want to enter camera here, what I have to do? I want to enter camera here from the script. What I have to do here? Yep, that's correct. Yep. That's correct, Harika. Yep. Any other cases from anyone? Now, how can I find the locator of this? Basically, we have to find the locator of this particular text box. So, right click, say inspect element with Firebug. Okay. If you are up here, first of all, look at ID. Now you have ID, so directly you can use this ID. If you don't have the ID, you can go for the name. If you don't have the name, check whether it is a link or not. If it is a link, take the link text. If it is not link, then probably you can go for XPath. Okay, XPath we will discuss. As of now, what you can do here, if you really come across a scenario like, if you don't have a ID, if you don't have a name, okay, if it is not a link, then you can probably look at the XPath. So as of now, if you really want an XPath, now go to Selenium IDE, record, take a new test case, record on a particular text box. So in that case, it is basically going to give the XPath. In the Selenium IDE, it is going to give the XPath. As of now, you can copy and use that XPath because we'll discuss in the coming classes. Right away, I don't want to make you scared. Okay? I don't want to scare all of you, so that's the reason I'm slowly, you know, making you understand the concepts. Okay. Now, basically, now this is the ID. So, browser dot find element. By ID. Okay. So, by highlighted line. Here, by using this highlighted line, what it is going to do? Basically, the highlighted line is going to recognize a particular object in the application. Okay. So once it recognizes, it gives a value back. Basically, it is going to refer a particular object. Technically, that is called as web element here in Selenium. The highlighted line basically it is going to recognize an object. Okay. Once it recognizes, it gives back an object called web element. Okay, we'll come back to that. So once it recognizes, what we want to do? First, we have to clear it. We have to clear the if we have any content. We have to clear it. Once we clear, we have to enter. Right, we have to enter some value here. For that, we have send keys. Okay, here. Say I want to enter camera here. Okay. So this is how we can enter a value into text box. Now after that, you want to click on the search button, right? Now use this point, this spy button and spy this particular object. Okay. Now see here, it has some ID. So you can use this ID. So you can enter camera here, and after that we want to click on search. Okay. After that we want to click on the daily deals. Again, spy this No, you don't agree here. First of all, try to see you have any ID here. Do we have ID here? In this highlighted part, do we have ID? Do we have a name? Okay, we don't have the ID, we don't have the name. Now, if we closely look at here, it is a link. How can I conclude this is a link? How can I conclude this is a link? How can I conclude whether it is a link or not? Yes, that's correct. You know, by looking at this tag, this tag, we can conclude it is a link. Okay. So here I'm taking this daily deals. Okay. So I conclude that this is a link. Suppose even it is not a link, then probably we have to depend on XPath. Okay. In that case, you have to open Selenium IDE, record it, and copy the XPath and use in the script. Now, click on daily deals. Okay. Now here. Meant by it is a link text, right? We are basically taking the text of the link. So I'm taking the locator as link text here. Okay. Dot click. I think yep, we have decided to tell this scenario. So now see here. Now we took a simple scenario and we were trying to automate this. Okay. Now I want to execute this. In how many ways we can execute a Java class? In how many ways we can execute and what are they? In two ways we can execute a Java class. One is main method, one is using annotation. Right. So now here I'm using annotation here. Now let us try to execute this. Now, any one of you here, if you have any question on today's this particular script, if any small question, please post in chat box. Okay, this is very very important. If you are able to write a script like this, as I said, you are almost done. If any one of you have any small question also, please post over here. And if it is clear for you, please mention it as clear. Here I can see around 20 students. So I can see either a question or around at least clear. Okay, let me to open the here. Yep, see here it is opening this EV application. Okay, now it has entered camera. Now it has clicked on search. Now it has to click on daily deals. Okay, see here, it is in the daily deals page. Okay, so it's very simple. Okay. Now for this concept, basically we are going to apply one more concepts. Like if I want to execute the same script on multiple browsers, okay. If I want to execute the same script with a different sets of values, okay. If sometimes application is not responding properly, in that case, which concept we are going to understand, okay. Now we have executed our script in Firefox, right? Here we have executed our script in Firefox, but I want to execute in Internet Explorer. Okay, I want to execute in Google Chrome. Okay, now see here. Now let me take a new script. Let me say simply multiple browsers. Now let me just copy this method. Okay. Now see here. Currently it is executing in Firefox browser. Okay. Now I want to execute the script in Google Chrome. Okay. Now if you want to execute in Google Chrome, now let me explain this. See here. As I said, there will be something called Chrome driver. So instead of creating instance for the Firefox, I will create the instance for the Chrome driver here. Now the key is here. Oh, give me a minute. Now just the key is, we are going to use the same instance name, same object name here. Okay. Now as of now, I'm just commenting this line. Okay. Here, instead of previously I was creating instance for the Firefox. Now I'm creating the instance for the this one, Chrome. Okay. Now I don't need to change anything here. Okay. See, in the scripts here, I don't need to change anything here because this get method is get this find element, this clear send keys are also part of this Chrome driver. How it is possible? Because in this Firefox driver and this Chrome driver, we have implemented the same Selenium WebDriver interface methods. Okay. That is where, in Selenium WebDriver interface, I was explaining that there will be same set of methods will be there in all the browsers. Okay. But the way of the logic internally it will be different. Okay. However, if you want to execute in Chrome driver, just create the instance for the Chrome driver. Okay. Now there is one more thing. Now say I don't know that. Let us try to execute this. Here I'm trying to execute this. This is going to throw an error here. This is throwing an error. Why? Because basically if you execute apart from the Firefox, say if you are trying to execute Chrome driver or if you are trying to execute on Internet Explorer, we have to download some extra software. It's a kind of add-on. It's not exactly add-on, it's a kind of a driver. Okay. So we need to have extra software apart from if you are trying to execute apart from Firefox. We need to have extra software. How can we know that? Yep. Just copy this error message here. Right click. You can say copy trace. Paste in your notepad here. Here I placed it in the notepad. Now somewhere if you see here, the path to the driver executable must be set by the web driver, Chrome driver. Okay, it is saying some information here, and moreover it is saying that just look at this website. Okay, now I'm just copying this. Let us go here. Probably this website, this URL is not properly working. We'll give it a try. Go to this downloads. No, this one. Here. Can you see that? If you observe here. Okay. 1 minute. Let me again paste here. What I have done, simply I have used Chrome driver here. So here we got an error. Copy that error. Paste in your notepad. Here it will show some link here. Copy that link. Okay. Why I am explaining this? Because you don't need to really remember all these things. Okay. You can just give a try. It is going to throw an error. Copy this. And here you will get a path here. Copy that path. Now see here. Here you have to download this. Okay. Click on this download Chrome driver. And here maybe probably you can download the latest one. I've used 2.9. Okay. Based on your type of operating system, you can download here. say if your operating system is Linux 32 bits, and if your operating system is Linux 64, you can download this. Okay, Mac, you can download this. Here it is saying Mac 32. And if you see here, you don't find anything like Mac 64. It means you can use Mac 32 for anything. I mean, it might be 32 or it might be 64, you can use this one. Even if you observe here, it is showing Win 32. It means it's Win 32 is going to work for both Windows 32 bit system or Windows 64 bit system. Okay. So you can use this Chrome driver Win 32. You can download this. In my system, it's already downloaded. I'm not going to download this. Okay. From your end, you can download this. Okay. Now, see here. Let me copy that part. Basically, here it is what here we have to use something called system. Set property. And here itself it is saying this is the property it is expecting. So if you read this, executable must be set by the webdriver.chrome.driver system property. That is where I am saying system set property. Here this is the property name. Okay. Basically they are saying that now we are going to execute the Chrome driver, and the Chrome driver executable file path is presented over here. Let me complete this and let me explain this. Let me get the path over here. I'm just trying to get from the previous plan. This is the Chrome driver path. If you see class, okay. See, I have here, there is something called Chrome driver here. Okay, Chrome driver, and if you observe here, Chrome driver underscore Win32. That is what I have downloaded. Okay, I already I downloaded this one. Okay, now see here, Chrome driver Win32, and I have extracted it, and this is the file. Now I have to point. Okay, I have to mention this over here. Now see here. So now here in our scripts, here you know system set property, this is the property and this is the value basically. .exe file. And moreover, it is one of the rule here in Selenium, of course it's not related to Selenium, it is basically related to Java. If you want to mention any path here this is a path, right? C class installation. Okay, so we have to make it as a regularize in the sense we have to make as of now Selenium is this Java is understanding that this is some kind of special characters. Okay, if you want to handle, just use one more slash here. In simple other words, in our scripts, if you are going to mention any path here, instead of single slash, use the double slash here. See here, I am using double slash. Now this error has been vanished. Okay. Now we understand this instance. Apart from that, I have mentioned one more line. Basically, because of this line, our Selenium program, first of all, it will try to it will make use of this Chrome driver in executing the script. In simple words, our script, our Java, this program is going to make use of this Chrome driver.exe executable file in executing the script. Okay, it's a kind of a supporting software. Okay, by using the supporting software, our script is going to execute in Chrome browser. Okay, you may ask, why don't we have a supporting software for Firefox? Basically, Selenium WebDriver and Selenium software itself is being developed purely on Firefox. Okay, there is we don't require any special softwares, any supporting software for Firefox, because purely Selenium has been designed based on the Firefox. Okay, basically Selenium RC started with Firefox only. So the skeleton of the Selenium WebDriver, I can say Firefox. So if you want to work on the other browsers, we have to basically download the supporting softwares, and we have to point to the supporting software, then we have to execute it. Okay, now see here, I'm executing this. Now the same scenario should execute in Google Chrome here. It's going to take a bit time. See, now it is opening a Google Chrome. Now it is opening eBay.com. As I said earlier, you know, if your browser in this state, basically Selenium will wait for it, wait till it gets stabilized. Okay, if you get this wait symbol, Selenium is going to wait till it gets stabilized. Now see, it is 100 camera. I clicked on search. Now once it clicked on search, then it has to click on the LEDs. Again, it is waiting over here. It is waiting this browser to stabilize. Okay, it seems it's clicked on daily deals. Okay, and see here, till now you ignored the status because again the browser was still in wait mode. I mean, still it is in searching mode here. See here, as still it is doing this kind of search, here in the background you don't see any green bar here. Can you all observe this? Now it got stabilized, then you got this browser, and then you got this green bar. Okay, now we have executed the script in Google Chrome. Okay, in a similar way we can also execute in Internet Explorer. Now we'll try to execute in Internet Explorer. See here again, if you want to execute in Internet Explorer, let me say our browser. Again, I'm using the same instance name, new. Again, you can follow the same way. Okay, now you can try to execute the script in Internet Explorer. Again, it is going to throw an error. Okay. Copy the error. Just paste in your notepad. Okay. Again, see here, it is asking us to look at this link here. Okay. Go to this link. Okay. Here, you can download. Go to downloads. Okay. On that one, these people are not maintaining properly. Yep, see here. Again, it comes to this download page. Okay, let me say. E driver. Yep, see here, you know, just go to this downloads page, select all downloads, search, and here you can find this IE driver server here. Okay. Again, based on the type of the operating system, I mean, basically Internet Explorer will install only on Windows. Okay. Probably I hope everyone knows about this point. Internet Explorer will be available only on Windows operating system. It is not going to be available in Linux and other operating system. Okay. And moreover, Again, based on your 32 bit, 64 bit, accordingly you can download this. Can you see here? IE driver Win32, IE driver 64. Based on the type of the system type, 32 bit system, 64 bit system, based on that, download this. Okay. Now, however, again, if you look at this, again, it is asking for to set the web driver IE driver system property. So, here we already have. Here, I'm just copying this. So, before this line, you have to use this. So, again, the system set property, I have used set property, and here I have IE driver executable file here in this. Okay, this one. Now let us try to execute this. Actually, earlier there was a problem here, there was a bug in the Internet Explorer. We'll see. Probably this might have got solved. We'll see. Actually, there was a problem earlier. I think we observed this problem in the last batch. There was a known issue in Internet Explorer. So, first of all, it has opened an Internet Explorer. Now it is trying to enter eb.com. It is trying to open a eb.com. Now it has to enter camera here. Is it entering or what it is doing? See here it is thrown error here. Okay. Can you all agree here? It is throwing an error. Basically there is a known issue over here. Okay. Probably if you want the information on this issue, I think here itself we have this. If you remember, you know, while explaining about the Selenium, during the advantages and disadvantages, I said, if you got stuck somewhere by the software, in Selenium, if you got stuck somewhere, I said, basically there is no official support, okay? But however, if you got stuck somewhere, you can raise your concern, you can raise the defects on Selenium, okay? And moreover, there will be, as I said, there will be a lot of forums available. Okay, if you see here, if you go to this particular page, this link, it is going to explain about this error. Okay, there is a known issue in this Internet Explorer. It seems it to be solved. Okay, this is the problem here. Okay, it is saying something about this Internet Explorer here. Okay, so there is a problem here. However, the concept is same, okay? Now, one more thing with respect to Internet Explorer here, it's very important. Internet Explorer, make sure the browser zoom level is 100%. Okay, make sure in the browser zoom level should be under 100% in Internet Explorer. What I'm talking about here, if you go here settings, this zoom level should be 100%. Say if you mention other than 100%, our script is going to throw an error. Okay, this is one of the prerequisites here in Internet Explorer. Okay, so if you mention 125% or if you mention anything other than 101 also, it is going to throw an error. It should be 100%. The zoom level should be 100%. Okay, and apart from that, as you understand that, for if you want to work on other than Firefox, basically we have to download the supporting softwares and we have to point that supporting softwares in our script. How to point? By using system.set property and by using this variable, we can point to that particular supporting software and we can execute it. Okay. So in real time, generally how we will write a logic here, Now, here I wrote the logic and I have commented here, right? Now, everyone up here, I will uncomment this. Basically, we'll handle using a kind of loop here. If loop. See here. Let me first of all take a string. Say s. S. Browser. Type equal to say Firefox. Okay. Now if browser type equals Firefox, else if browser type equals say Chrome. We already understand this if else conditions, nested if conditions. Again, else if as browser type equals, okay, here let me say IE here. Generally we will write the logic like this. Okay, so what happened? I mentioned here browser type Firefox here. Okay, so if I pass Firefox, it is going to pick this logic. Okay, if I pass here IE, it should pick this one. Okay, if I don't pass anything, basically accordingly we have to say that you did not pass the appropriate value, then we have to stop our step. Okay. So I have mentioned basically a nested if condition. So whatever the value that you are going to pass from here, based on that, accordingly our script is going to pick the browser. Okay. So however, apart from these browsers, apart from this Firefox, Chrome, Internet Explorer, we have a Safari, we have a Android browsers, we have other browsers. Okay. Similar approach. We are going to have a similar approach. We don't have a Netscape and Safari here. Generally, in our Windows operating system, we'll not basically test with those browsers. Okay, for other browsers, have a similar approach. Apart from these browsers, what are the browsers that we have been understanding, and what are the browsers we know? Apart from this, there is something called HTML unit driver. Okay, apart from this, there is something called HTML unit driver. Basically, it does not have any GUI. It will not have any GUI. Okay, it executes the script in background. It executes scripts in background. Okay. Now let me show this. See here. As of now, let me intentionally mention ABCD here, so that it is not going to get into this loop. Or maybe probably let me use HTML unit driver. Okay. So here again let me use some more else if condition. If this browser type equals, if it is equals to this HTML unit driver, I wanted to execute. See here. Our browser HTML unit driver, our browser, this one. Okay. Here again, we don't need to set any property here. Okay. And okay, by default, say it's going to be expired this. Let me say null. We'll see how it is going to be. Give a minute. Yeah, basically, it is expecting this variable to declare some value here. I will explain about this bit later. Okay. Why it has to rename? Give a minute. I'm declaring as a class variable. Yeah. I'll come back to this bit later. Okay. Now see here. I mentioned HTML unit driver, and basically it is going to it is getting into this HTML unit driver. Okay. Now see here. Now let us try to execute here. Now everyone observe here. Now you can't see anything here. Now it will not open any browser. Okay. So it is taking some time here. Now can you see here? It is showing an error. Probably. Why it could not open eb.com? Null pointer exception.
At Firefox you said ends with. If browser ends with.
But I don't
think it should be equals, right?
Yeah, that should be equals, but there is another issue here or here. Okay, as of now, just to understand this, we'll come back to this topic. As of now, I'm just trying to execute like this. Okay. And let me comment this. I'm just commenting this. First of all, we'll understand this HTML unit driver. Okay. Now, everyone observe here. Now, it's not showing anything here for us. So, basically, it is executing in the background. Okay, now you can observe over here, after a bit time, once it executes, it is going to say pass or fail. Now can you see here, it's showing a green bar, but it does not open any browser, it does not open any Firefox, it does not open anything, and it is still saying pass, right? So as I said, HTML unit driver, it does not have any GUI, graphical user interface, it just executes in the background, and shows the result. But how can I conclude whether it is executing correctly or not? We'll do one thing. See here. Here we have a locator, right? For this locator, we intentionally mentioned one error here. Let me say 1, 2, 3. Can you all observe this? I'm intentionally changing this location, locator. Now let us try to execute this. Now I'm expecting that there should be an error because there might not be an object with 1, 2, 3, right? Now see here, it is throwing an error, no such element exception. And if you go here, if you double click on this line, see here, it is highlighting this line. It means it executes in the background, right? So as this object is not there, it is throwing an error. Okay. Now let me remove this. Okay. So HTML unit driver, basically this is the browser which is generally used by the developers to test their logic. Okay, developers uses this HTML unit driver to test their logic, and moreover the execution will be very fast here. Okay, execution will be very fast because we don't have the UI. It will be fast than UI browsers. Okay, generally it will be used by the developers. However, we can also use this. Okay, we can also use this HTML unit driver in our script. Basically, just if you want to test whether our script is going to work properly or not, in this case, probably you can execute in your HTML unit driver. Okay. Now we'll try to fix this issue. It's just a Java initialization initialization problem. Now let us try to exit from here. It's a null pointer exception. What's the wrong here? Same one, right? Okay, give a minute.
Hi, Kumar.
One minute.
I think no need to mention the files. Okay.
No, actually we have been understanding this one. Firefox, Google Chrome, Internet Explorer and Unit Driver. Okay, we understood this and we executed the script in these browsers, like running the Selenium scripts in different browsers with Eclipse and JNet. Okay, we have been understanding this one. If you all agree here, next topic is debugging scripts in Eclipse. Okay, it means it's a debugging process. Okay, actually here we are able to find we have an issue, right? If we have any issue in our scripts, basically we can resolve by using something called debugging process. Okay, probably we'll apply this concept, this debugging concept over here on this error. Okay, we'll discuss in the next session. Give a minute.
H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.